There's several techniques that have been used for years in museums to help prepare skeletons for the collections. And some of the techniques are not very pleasant. One is called maceration, and that's where you take an animal, fleshed out animal, put it in a jar of warm water, seal the lid, and put it on the shelf for a while. And you can imagine what that smells like when that process is done. The technique we use here at the museum are called dermestid beetles, which are a type of flesh-eating beetles. And we have a tank here full of beetles. And with this technique, you take an animal, and you don't take a whole animal. Some people think we take a whole dead animal, drop it in the box, and the beetles strip it clean. There's a lot of prep work that goes into it before that. So what we do is skin the animal, take the hide off, take all the organs out, take the brain out usually. So then you have basically a fleshed out animal that you lay in a tray. Each animal goes in its own tray so we don't mix up any bones. And the larva of the beetles is what does most of the work. So once it's put in, the adults will come and lay eggs on it, and the eggs will hatch and we'll get these small larvae. And the larvae are hungry. Their job is to eat, to grow up to be adults. So they'll eat voraciously and they'll strip all the flesh, the dried flesh, off the specimens. We use these collections for many things. One is it's an identification resource. So when people find bones in their backyard, or we work with law enforcement identifying bones from forensic cases, we're able to use our collection as like a three-dimensional textbook. But it's a great technique. They do beautiful work, and it saves us a lot of time and effort.